Duane, congratulations on the win. Playing a third game in 3 days, legs were going to be a thing. You had 5 points at the half, and when it seemed like you might wear down, that's when you seemed to rise up in this one. What did it take to dig in and to make that run in the second half that you guys did to put them away?
For me, man, I told the guys that, you know, we've been doing this our whole lives, playing every day, playing multiple games in a day. I tried to just break it down and make it that simple. It's like AAU, summertime, traveling, staying in the hotel and playing basketball games with your brother. So, you know, coach gave us a good motivational talk at halftime. Told me and EJ, we need to step it up, and all the guys to step it up. You know, we weren't shooting the ball great, missed some easy bunnies in the first, and just had to come out in the second and lock in a little bit more. I got something to go early, hit my first one. So at that point, I just knew I really want this. Our guys really want this. And, you know, it's now or never. So, you know, those legs started to get back under me, and we were able to finish the game.
Ready? We'll go next to Stephen Means, Cleveland.com.
When I think we've asked you a similar question, is can you just describe what type of style of a leader you are?
A positive leader. That's my go-to thing. Positive energy, manifest greatness. That's what I abide by. So keeping my guys positive and making sure that they're confident in themselves.
We'll go next to Bill Landis from The Athletic.
Duane, I think a lot of people see that positivity from you when you're on the floor, but I'm wondering if you feel like you need to ratchet it up even more when late in the game Michigan starts clawing back and they have an opportunity to win a game that you guys were leading by double digits.
Yeah, you know, basketball is a game of runs. You know, we definitely are going to continue to learn from these games that we've been playing. You know, they've been coming down to the wire and you know, but we've been doing a good job. You know, we just got to stick to what we've been doing, stay confident in each other, keep believing in what we got going on.
All righty, next up, Whitney Harding. Whitney.
Hey, Duane. Yesterday when I asked you and Chris about playing Michigan, you guys said the defense had to improve, and it did today. How much have you guys – how does that show that you guys have learned so much since the last few weeks?
Yeah, effort and details. I think, you know, putting our heads to bed last night, we knew those were the two things that we needed to focus on, effort, details, and winning the rebounding battle. And I think we definitely won those effort plays, those 50-50 balls. CJ, early in the second half, threw his whole body on the court, got one, threw it to me, and then we ended up getting an and one on that possession. So stuff like that is what got us this W tonight.
Alrighty, next up, Pat Murphy, 247.
Duane, after you guys played Michigan last time, you said you would see them again, and you brought that up yesterday. Did this one mean a little bit more to you, given, you know, rivalry, what they did on your court, and obviously what was on the line getting to the championship?
Yeah, definitely, man. You know, everybody knows that we lost to them earlier in the year. It was one of the best college basketball games, if not the best of the year. So, you know, a lot of hype, a lot of energy, a lot of excitement. We were really excited for this one. And we got the one that quote unquote mattered, and we're moving on. So super excited for tomorrow and what's in store.
All righty, next up, Colin Hess-Hill, 11 Warriors.
Duane, I think you're above 50% from three against Michigan in your career. And I know you mentioned Grand Rapids after the game. What's about you and these specific matchups that has led you to play so well?
You know, I don't think about it too much, other than that I am from Grand Rapids and I'm a Michigan kid. You know, everybody wanted to go to Michigan State growing up. So, where I'm from, at least. So, it's just, you know, that extra little chip in the back of my head, and I'm on the rivals or I'm on the dark side now for the guys back home. But in Columbus, I went to the good side. So, all those things are jumbling through my mind, but you know, gamers do gamer things and players make plays, and just try to go out there and do whatever I got to do for my team to win.
All righty, we'll do two more with Duane here. We'll go to Steve Hellwagon. Steve.
Yeah, Duane, just your thought. I mean, the lead had gone 12 to 10 to 8 to 6 to 4 to 1, and they got a shot in the air to win it. I mean, what's going through your mind on that last possession? Can't foul, and he can't make it. Just what's going through your mind when that ball's in the air?
Yeah, obviously you got to move on from everything that happened. You know, obviously we were up 12. They got it to 1. You know, the last huddle we had before we actually turned the ball over for them to get another shot up on the rim, coach said, hey, forget about everything else. We have one job. We got to score and get a stop. And, you know, we didn't score. And I looked at our guys and said, hey, this is it. This is the one. This is the last 30 seconds working out with Coach Q. This is it. Like, finish. And then we pulled it out.
Thank you. All righty. We'll wrap Duane up with Doug Lamarice. Doug.
Duane, could you describe the feeling of when you guys are on the court and you're connected and you're at your best and just what it feels like? There feel like there are moments with this team when it's just all flowing together. What's it like when you're in that moment?
Yeah, there's no words to describe the feeling, because I know exactly what you're talking about, and there's no words to describe it, man. It's second to none. You feel it in your blood when you're connected out there with your brothers. And it's one of the best feelings in the world, I'll tell you that for sure.